My dear children, welcome to the EBS online class. Hope you all are safe and staying healthy at home. We have completed semester 1 textbook. So today let's start a new lesson from our semester 2 textbook. All of you keep your semester 2 textbook with you. Have you all had your breakfast? What did you eat today for breakfast? Dosa, idli, chapati? Okay. So, why do you eat food? We are having breakfast, lunch, dinner. We are eating different types of food. Why do we eat different types of food? What happens to the food when it enters our body? We shall discuss all these things in our new lesson. Lesson 1, Food and Digestion. Why do we eat food? Yes. Food gives us energy. We need energy to do all our activities. We get energy from the food we eat. Anything else? Food gives only energy to our body? No. Food also helps in the growth of our body. It also helps to keep us away from diseases and helps to stay healthy. So food gives us energy. It helps in the growth of our body. It fights diseases and helps to keep us healthy. There are certain substances in food that gives us energy, that helps in the growth of our body and also keeps us away from diseases. These substances are called as nutrients. So what are nutrients? Nutrients are substances in food that is needed to live and grow. There are different types of nutrients. Some nutrients gives us energy, some nutrients helps in the growth of our body, and some nutrients helps to keep us away from diseases. All the nutrients are not present in the same food. Different nutrients are present in different foods. So to get all the nutrients and to remain healthy, we should eat different foods. The main types of nutrients are carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins and minerals. So to get all these nutrients, we must eat different foods rich in these nutrients. Also, our body needs roughage and water for the healthy functioning of our body. Apart from these nutrients, roughage and water is also needed. So our food must also contain roughage and water. So first let's discuss about carbohydrates. Carbohydrates are the nutrients that gives energy to our body. So carbohydrates are called as energy giving nutrient. There are two types of carbohydrates, that is sugar and starch. So carbohydrates are the energy giving nutrients. It provides energy to our body. There are two types of carbohydrates, sugar and starch. So to get energy, we must eat food rich in carbohydrates. Do you know some food items rich in carbohydrates? Rice, wheat and maize are rich in carbohydrates. So we get carbohydrate by eating dosa, chapati, bread, cooked rice, etc. Potatoes and bananas are also rich in carbohydrates. The next one is proteins. Proteins helps in the growth of the body. It also helps to repair the damaged body parts. So proteins are called as bodybuilding nutrient. Carbohydrates are called as energy giving nutrient because it provides energy to our body. Proteins are called as bodybuilding nutrient because it helps in the growth of our body and also helps to repair the damaged body parts. Food items rich in protein are milk, egg, meat, cheese, etc. Soya bean is the richest source of protein. The next nutrient is fat. Fats are also energy giving nutrients. We studied carbohydrates are energy giving nutrients. Fats are also energy giving nutrients, but our body needs only very little fat. These fats are stored in our body for future use. When our body does not get enough energy from the food, it uses the energy stored as fat. Fat also provides warmth to our body. Cooking oil, butter, cheese, and nuts are rich in fats. Then there are vitamins and minerals. Vitamins and minerals helps our body to work properly, to fight diseases, and also helps to keep us healthy. So vitamins and minerals are called as protective foods or protective nutrient, because vitamins and minerals helps our body to work properly, fight diseases, and stay healthy. So they are called as protective foods. Fresh fruits, vegetables, milk, meat, egg, etc. are rich in vitamins and minerals. There are different types of vitamins. Do you know the different types of vitamins? Vitamin A, B, C, D, E, and K are the different types of vitamins. Minerals like calcium and iron is also important for our body. Calcium is an important mineral needed for the healthy bones and teeth. Milk and green leafy vegetables are rich in calcium. Iron is a mineral needed for the formation of blood. Meat, beans, and green leafy vegetables are rich in iron. So these are the five types of nutrients: carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins, and minerals. Now I'll show the picture of different foods. You have to identify the nutrient in it. This is egg. Which nutrient is present in it? Yes, it is protein. This is banana. It is rich in carbohydrate. Then nuts. Nuts are rich in fats. Here it is milk. Milk is rich in protein. It is also an excellent source of vitamins and minerals like calcium. Calcium is important for the healthy bones and teeth. These are green leafy vegetables. It is rich in minerals like iron, which is needed for the formation of blood. Fruits and vegetables are also rich source of vitamins and minerals.
Apart from these nutrients, our body also needs roughage and water. What is roughage? The indigestible substance in plant food is known as roughage. It is also called as fiber. Indigestible means cannot be digested. So our body cannot digest the roughage, but it helps to remove waste from our body. So what is roughage? The indigestible substance in plant food is called roughage. It is also called fiber. It helps to remove waste from our body. Another important component needed for the healthy functioning of our body is water. Water helps in the proper digestion of food. It helps to absorb nutrients properly, and it also helps to remove waste from our body. Our body needs 3 liters of water every day. About 2 liters of water comes from the food we eat and drink. So we should drink 2 liters of water every day, that is 8 glasses of water. So all of you should drink 8 glasses of water every day. So today we have discussed about different types of nutrients, their functions, and also about roughage and water. Hope you all have understood the topic. I have attached the notes of this lesson along with this video. So write the notes neatly in your notebook. Read textbook page number 1 and 2 from notebook. Study question number 1, 2, 3 from fill in the blanks. And question number 1, 2, 3 from name the following. A test paper is also attached along with this. Do the test and submit it. Study well. Let's meet in the next class. Thank you.